what the hell's going on around here. Dutch is crazy as a cat herder. Mike and Bill are turning all kinds of screws on me. The only way this is going to end is with a big old hole in Uncle's head.
Thank you. Don't worry. Thank you so much.
Well, we ain't done yet, Abigail. Dutch seems...
to have lost his mind? And no.
Just be careful.
I don't have to be careful. I have you as a friend.
Okay. Guess I'll see you later then.
I guess.
Hey, Sadie.
All right there, Arthur.
Not exactly a welcome home party.
Well, you warned me.
Mr. Morgan.
I'll fill you in some more later. Herr Strauss.
How are you?
About how I look.
Okay.
Are you perhaps available for some work?
Debtors?
Yes.
I guess.
Your commitment to your duties is admirable. You know, Mr. Morgan, you are...
Well, I'm sorry for you.
No, never mind. I didn't...
Look, Strauss.
You take care.
I ain't dead yet.
No, of course not. That's what I was saying. I...
The debtors, Strauss. Who owes you money?
There's a deserter from Fort Wallace. Head to him first. They're looking for him out on the road near Three Sisters. Man's name is J. John Weathers.
J. John Weathers.
Then there's a miner over in Annisburg. He's called Arthur. Like you.
Huh.
Arthur Londonderry. Family man, desperate, you know the type.
Couldn't one of the boys do this?
I tried. They lacked your vigor.
Vigor, huh? All right.
Take care, Mr. Morgan.
Oh, pal.
Easy there. Time to go, boy. Giddy up. Go. Easy. J. John Weathers.
They call me Snow Goose now.
Whatever they call you. You borrowed money off of Leopold Strauss. The bills come due.
This ain't the best time, sir.
This ain't the best time for anyone.
Mr. Strauss knew it was a long-term proposition.
The debt is due.
Okay. I got supplies meant to last through the winter. You can take them, just... Is there any way you can help me? I stay out here, there won't be anyone to pay you.
I ain't here to help. I'm here to collect. We're all of us up against it.
Look, there's men after me. They're killers. I ain't a deserter, just an objector. It ain't right. If there was another way than running, I need your help.
Shut up.
Please.
Up here, it's him.
It's too late.
Form up, we shoot on sight.
I clear off, sir.
Shit! Well, seeing as I'm here, I'll do what I can for you.
It's all right, my darling. You can come out.
Oh, crap. I probably should have helped you fix the damn wagon.
We could probably still save something.
Really now?
Look, you can take the silver locket for the debt.
Damn the dad. Just get her somewhere safe. Go on.
Thank you, fella. You know, there ain't enough kindness in this world, that's for sure. But you...
I don't know nothing about kindness.
You there? Can you help? Can you help me, mister?
What's the problem?
My goddamn horse got spooked and run off.
You hurt?
Not too bad, at least. But he took my damn leg.
Sorry.
He went that way, I think. His name's Buell.
Buell?
Second time a prick named Buell cost me a leg.
Huh?
Buell was my general. When I lost it.
Okay.
Anyway, if you see an angry bastard of a horse with my wooden leg, I'd be real grateful.
I'll bear that in mind. Whoa, easy. Shit, spooked all right. Whoa. Take it easy there. Whoa, now, easy. Easy there. Okay, boy. Now, come on, Dan. Let's get you back.
Easy.
Easy, boy.
Easy. It's okay. Whoa. Easy.
Yeah. He's just where you left him. Can't go far with that leg in your stirrup. Can't go bucking him like that. So you better be good, you hear? I get the notion he's not a man you want to cross. No matter how big and strong you are. Nothing gonna spook you here. Come on. You're not so nasty. I found him.
You're a good man, mister. Mr.
Arthur. You're right. He's a brute.
Hamish Sinclair. Yeah, he's a great horse, aside from when the devil got him. Hey, you wanna hand me that leg there, please? And while you're at it, give old Buell a kick for me, would you?
No, I'm only kidding.
Thank you. Warren, but a snake that spooked him. You're a real gentleman, you know?
Sometimes, maybe. Yeah, how'd you lose a leg?
Oh, in the war. Cannonball. Pretty clean, though. I don't have much pain, and I didn't get any gangrene. Young boy went into battle with me, got cut in half, so all things considered, I'm doing pretty well, I guess.
Yeah, I guess. So, how is the false one?
It's okay. I can still hunt, fish, enjoy the outside. Weren't sent too crazy by it. Anyway, I ain't got much to pay you with.
You know, that's okay.
You like fishing? You come with me someday. I know some pretty good spots.
I'm a pretty poor fisherman.
Yeah, well, I'm great, so between the two of us, we do okay. My cabin is right over on the other side of O'Cray's run there. Thanks again. You throw me again, you old dumb bastard, I'm gonna put a bullet in you. I'll see you again.
Okay, feller.
Yep.
Whoa, whoa! Hey, boy.
Yep.
Faster.
Easy, boy. Gotta be done. Hey there, partner.
Morning there. All right, sir. You got any business at the mine?
I'm looking for an Arthur Londonderry. I was told he works here.
Londonderry? Oh, you'll want to speak to the foreman. He's down in the pit.
Arthur Londonderry. Is he here?
I'm sorry, feller, but you're too late. Arthur's dead.
The man's dead. What's wrong with you?
Oh, boy. You can't exactly beat it out of him now, can you? You might get something off his widow just across from Butcher's Creek, but I'd hurry. You ain't gonna be the only one a-knockin'.
You ought to be ashamed of yourself.
Hey, I ain't the godforsaken moneylender.
This here's private, you know.
What?
okay there. Yeah. Easy now.
With you.
Gonna pack all your stuff, Angel?
I don't wanna go.
It'll be an adventure.
I don't want an adventure. I want my daddy.
Mrs. Londonderry.
Arthur's dead.
I know. I'm sorry for it. It's just we lent Arthur some money, you see, and.
So it was you. You son of a bitch. What do you want now? You want my boy's shoes? You want the food out of our bellies, what little there is? You want me to lie down for you?
No, no.
Arthur gave everything to pay your bills. Everything. And now there's some fellas coming to take the house. There ain't nothing left, mister.
Just wanted to say the debt's canceled and to take this. It won't bring your husband back, I know. You need money and I don't.
Well, you're a good man. I just wish you'd done it before he worked himself into the grave. But you know, maybe you and your friend that lent him the money could do things differently. Like, not threaten a man. Excuse me.
I'm sorry, ma'am. I really am.